In this video, we'll see how to manipulate data for a given date range and for a specific time duration. So the example we'll see is to sum all orders received in last 1 week between 6 a.m. and 6 p.m. So this is a sample data that I have. So if you can see, only the last 3 records, you'll see the orders were received between 6 a.m. and 6 p.m. And for these records, the order was received like outside this time range. So we are interested to get to see only the sum of these 3 records for the last 1 week. So now I will show you how to do it in Oracle SQL. Right. So this is the table which has this information, select star from order details. So the first step is to get records for the last 7 days, where we will say where order date is greater than 6 date minus 7. So now I have got all the records that we are interested for the last 7 days, but now I want to sum only for the time between 6 a.m. and 6 p.m. So sum between 6 a.m. to 6 p.m. in 24 hours format, we can say it's 0600 to 1800. So we will use the 24 hours format logic to get the details only for between 6 and 18 hours. Between 6 and 18 hours we will try to get. So first step, what I will do is I will just say select to care of order underscore date. I am interested in only in this particular format. In this particular format. So from order underscore details, and I will say where order underscore date is greater than 6 date minus 7. Okay, so let's run this. And the next step is we need to convert this to char into two numbers so that we can apply the filter. I will say two number, and then I will get it. So now if you see two number, there should be a opening bracket here. So let's run this. Right, so now this is getting converted into only in number. So we are interested between 600 to 1800, only those records for which we have to get the total amount. So what we will do is select, and then we will say case when, copy this, copy the whole thing, select case when two number of this is between 600 and 1800, then I want the order underscore amount, else I want 0, and then I will do an end here. Right, so let me run the SQL now. What it says, let's see, it says error at this particular line, then order underscore amount, else 0, end. I can okay, so now we'll see how, what's the error. Okay, I'm getting an error here. So case when two number is between 600 and 800, then I want order underscore amount, else 0, and then I'm saying end. Okay, so I really don't know what is the problem here. Let me check what I have written. Okay, between 600, then order amount, else 0, end. So there is nothing wrong here. Okay, but we'll find out, we'll figure it out what's the problem here. Okay, I don't need a bracket here. Let me remove the bracket here and also the bracket here, and let me run this now. Okay, it says, okay, this is the file. Missing keyword. So now you get 00 for all the records, and then 1355, 1335, 4355, 4, 4, 4, 4, 4, 4, 4, 4, 4, 8. So now what we have to simply do is we have to use the sum function on top of this and then get the total order amount for a time period. Total order amount. I'm just giving an alias. So we are getting the total order amount as 9448. And what we see here is also 9448. So what we have done is we converted into HS24MI format. And then this HS24MI format, I'm converting it to two number and then I'm checking it between 600 and 1880. This is wrong. It should be between 600 and 1800. Okay. And then we get order amount in those cases. Else we are saying 0, n, and then the total order amount. So if you want only those specific records, right, if I'm interested in to get only those records between this time range. Here we are getting the sum. But if you are interested to get only those records between this time, I will just say select star from order underscore details. Okay. You can say where order underscore details, where order date between this, and then I can say and. Okay, I can say two care of order date between this and this value. So what you will see, what we are getting here, right? I'll get only those three records what we see here, right? So this is another scenario where we can use it in the where condition as well. I'm winding up this video with this, and I do conduct a one-to-one training, Oracle SQL and PL SQL training. So if you are interested, you can reach out to me in this email ID. Thank you.